In this video, we'll put the most hyped design-to-code tool, Lovable, head-to-head against today's leading code generators, ChatGPT, Gemini, and Claude. We'll use the exact same image and prompt in each tool to see which one generates accurate, ready-to-use code. Make sure you subscribe to stay ahead with the latest tools and tech insights. If you're watching this intro on social media, check the description or comments for the full tutorial. Let's dive in. All right, let's start by finding a login page design on Dribbble. Something simple, clean, and easy to code. Perfect. I found just the right one. No complicated images or fancy structures. I'll quickly grab a screenshot, leaving out the mockup. Now, let's test some AI tools to see who creates the best code from this design. Starting with ChatGPT, I'll upload the screenshot with a simple prompt. Convert this to HTML and CSS. While ChatGPT gets going, let's quickly set up the same test with Gemini, Lovable, and Claude. And they're off. ChatGPT finished super fast. Impressive speed. Gemini's done now too. But Lovable seems a bit confused. It started creating a React component, even though I specifically asked for plain HTML and CSS. Not exactly the best start. Meanwhile, Claude just wrapped up. Nicely timed. And so far, it looks amazing. The code is also well structured. The design is almost identical to the original design. Let's check how Lovable is doing. An error. Great. And this was certainly not what we wanted. Despite the React mishap, the design itself is surprisingly good, but the circle and Google icon are off. Let's correct it to generate plain HTML and CSS, not a React project. Okay, it lost the context and is asking us to upload the image again. And as you can see, the response is quite slow. So while it's still generating, let's check how Gemini is performing. Since there's no online preview option, I'll go ahead and download the files to preview them locally. Wow, it looks fantastic. Clean, accurate, responsive, and it almost nailed the circle perfectly. Claude's turn, and it's really impressive. Great design accuracy, responsive, and even attempted the blur effect nicely. Okay, let's see how Lovable is catching up. And it has generated a great design. Let me download it and preview it locally. Quick usability note, Lovable doesn't seem to offer direct download or copy options easily. Claude definitely wins here, as copying from Lovable manually wasn't ideal. Okay, it looks great overall, but the blurred circle part is not quite right. Let's move on to the ChatGPT results and see how it looks. We have generated it on the default 4.0 model, and it would be an unfair comparison, since the real hype is about 0.4 mini and 0.3. I'll regenerate with 0.4 mini high. Ouch, 0.4 mini looks like we traveled back to 2010. Now, let's give ChatGPT another chance with its other models. Well, it's getting worse, isn't it? Okay, let's give a chance to 0.3. The 0.3 model did better, but still pretty basic compared to Gemini and Claude, and it totally messed up the circle. Let me reorganize everything for the final showdown. Side by side, here's how each tool performed. ChatGPT 4.0, 0.4 mini high, 0.3, Gemini, Claude, Lovable. Let's look at the code. Gemini did a great job, especially with the addition of custom fonts. The code is understandable and the correct form fields are used. Lovable also did a great job. It even added comments. ChatGPT 4.0 also generated well-structured code with clean CSS. On the other hand, 0.4 mini and 0.3 generated minified CSS, which is hard to understand and modify for a non-coder. Finally, Claude. I am really impressed with the output. It is modern, well-structured, and easy to understand, maintain, and modify. It even used SVG icons directly in the HTML instead of loading third-party resources. Okay, here are my final thoughts on this. Context awareness, ChatGPT, Gemini, Lovable, Claude. Design accuracy, ChatGPT, Gemini, Lovable, Claude. Code quality, ChatGPT, Gemini, Lovable, Claude. Response speed, ChatGPT, Gemini, Lovable, Claude. What are your thoughts? Did your favorite AI tool win? Let me know down in the comments and feel free to suggest other design-to-code platforms you'd like to see tested. Don't forget to hit the like button if you enjoyed this comparison and subscribe for more exciting experiments. See you next time.